Hi everyone, welcome back. Today you will be hearing a story, Abhijit Banerjee's Detective Stories, Chapter 1, The Criminal of Hyderabad by Rudranil Lahiri. Hope you like it. 1. Abhijit Banerjee is a historian. Okay, let me tell you the truth. He is a public detective. Yes, a public detective. He studied science, not arts. But he gives his identity to people as historian. Almost in every mission, he is accompanied by his brother Achintya Banerjee. Achintya is his own brother. Achintya wants to become like his big brother. His big brother's age is around 36 and his own age is 25. So, you will now get to know about their adventure, in which you will get quite an interesting mystery. So, will you go? Asked Abhijit. Sure, answered Achintya. Will anyone else accompany? Asked Abhijit. Won't Avinash go? Asked Achintya. He is not good. Anyone else? Aritra? Asked Achintya again. Let me call him. Abhijit called him and ended the call within 5 minutes. Next, he said, he has another plan. Leave all those. We two will only go. Pack your bag and make your own trolley. Mom, where is mine? Next words can't be heard as he ran towards the room. Achintya started packing his bag. After packing clothes and other necessities, he started looking for an arm. He did not get anything. He went to Abhijit. Abhijit had also finished packing by then. At last, he opened his drawer. His Charter Arms revolver came out. Whenever Achintya sees the revolver, his heart starts to beat faster. Abhijit packed his revolver inside his clothes, and in the drawer were also some extra bullets, which he packed. 3. On Sunday, they left. They boarded on the flight on time. After takeoff, Abhijit said to Achintya, this time try to use your own brain a bit. Achintya yet didn't know why they are going to Hyderabad. Now he asked Abhijit, brother, why are we going to Hyderabad? Achintya understood by the clue of his last words, try to use your own brain this time, and his brother took with him the revolver. Abhijit asked, might be something is there, isn't it? After their enjoyable flight journey, they landed in the airport. After customs, they booked an auto rickshaw to their hotel, Hotel Prakash. After settling their luggage in the room and as they freshened up, Abhijit said, let's go for lunch. Get ready. We have to book another auto rickshaw. On his brother's confusing words, Achintya said, I saw the board, brother. There is a restaurant in this hotel. No, dear, said Abhijit. We would go to a restaurant. Picking up his iPhone, he said, and here is the address. Achintya still could not understand what was happening and what was Abhijit doing. It was all clear when they reached the restaurant. At the gate was waiting Mr. Sushant. After meeting Mr. Sushant, he said, perfect timing, Abhijit, perfect timing. So how are you, Achintya? Achintya answered, fine. How are you, uncle? I am also fine. How are you doing, Abhijit? As everyone is doing, answered Abhijit, smiling. Let's go inside. It's quite hot here. I am feeling as if I am in an oven. It's really very hot in Hyderabad. After they ordered lunch, they chatted on various topics. Achintya also participated. After the delicious lunch at the restaurant, Mr. Sushant asked, so, which hotel are you in? Achintya answered, Hotel Prakash. Mr. Sushant said, my car is there, I'll drop you. Also, I have to discuss something with you, remember? At the room of Hotel Prakash, Mr. Sushant sat on the bed. Next to Mr. Sushant was Abhijit, and next to him was Achintya. Mr. Sushant was the commander of public detectives. Abhijit was a high-level public detective. For his great works in the field of detective work, he is liked by Mr. Sushant. Also, Achintya is liked by him for his ambition and brevity. Resting on the bread, Mr. Sushant said, "Crime is increasing day by day, Abhijit, day by day. Anyways, have you heard of Pawan Singh?" Achintya's eyebrows got crooked. Abhijit said, "The criminal who is now in jail." With a smile, Mr. Sushant said, "You made a small mistake." "Not is, he was in jail."
"Did he run?" asked Abhijit.
"Not only did he run, but also formed a new team and started his work."
"What about his old team?" asked Abhijit.
"Two of his old team members are there. Rest we couldn't catch. Anyways, I think his old team members came back."
"Sir, you told that he started his work. What did he do?" asked Abhijit.
The answer came from Mr. Sushant. "He is transferring our country's valuables to another country."
"Anyways, it is still not clear whether he is doing it or not. But we are suspecting him, as just the day he ran from jail, crimes began. Everything was ready itself."
Abhijit said, "How can that be possible? At least, he will need 1 month to start those works, and another question is, how did he run away?"
Mr. Sushant said, "I haven't called you like this. Anyways, I will inform you once we get to know anything. So now, what will you do?
Go and visit the Charminar and Hussein Sagar. I don't know whether fort will be opened or not. I can send you a car for these days if you want. You may require. And remember one thing, what is your occupation?"
"I am a historian and my purpose to visit Hyderabad is just tour," said Abhijit.
Achintya was silent till now. Now he said, "Uncle, what's there in Hussein Sagar?"
Mr. Sushant said, smiling,
"Hussein Sagar is a heart-shaped lake. It was built by Ibrahim Quli Qutb Shah and it was built in 1563. And a large statue of Gautama Buddha stands on the Gibraltar rock in the middle of the lake. Rest you will know when you reach."
So, after taking a little rest, Abhijit said to Achintya, "I just can't stay like this. Let's go. Not to Hussein Sagar. First police station, then Hussein Sagar. Get ready. And yes, keep your eyes and ears open throughout. Once I came, I will solve the mystery."
They got ready and went for police station. There was their car. Mr. Sushant has sent their car. It was an Alto K10. Abhijit sat in the front seat and Achintya at the back. The driver was Mr. Datta, Santosh Datta. Abhijit started talking to him.
"Where do you live?"
In the town nearby."
"Whose car is this?"
"This car is of the government for guests."
"So, sir, where to go first?"
"Police station first," said Abhijit.
Achintya said, "Why are we going to police station?"
Abhijit answered, "Just for some questions and to know who the OC is." Reaching to the police station, Abhijit said to Mr. Santosh, "Park the car anywhere, but give me your number. You will come once I call you. We will go to see the Charminar and Hussein Sagar." They exchanged their phone numbers and Abhijit and Achintya went in. The OC of the police station said,
"Yeah, what's your purpose?"
Abhijit took out one of his cards and handed it to the OC. The OC then said,
"Oh sir, come in. Will you have tea?"
Abhijit said, "No, and sir, you know my work. Please, can you hide my card?" The OC said,
"Yes, yes.
So sir, what's the purpose of you to come to police station?"
Abhijit said, "I heard something about the running away of jail of Pawan Singh."
"That's true, sir. He isn't there. He ran away."
"How did he manage to escape?" asked Abhijit.
"Don't know, sir. All I know that is his work is started. he started to transfer valuables from our country, said the OC.
And how did you understand he is doing all these things? Asked Abhijit.
Sir, we aren't sure who is doing, but yes, as he ran away from jail, the works began.
A few days before, a man's bag was being checked in the airport and it was found that he was carrying some sorts of valuables.
The police asked him and saw his fields. At last it was proven that he was innocent.
It happens thrice. Still we don't know what's happening. Once it is carried by an innocent person and how is it then given to the team of Pawan?
Abhijit said, two of his companions are still in jail, right?
Yes, sir, said the OC.
Sir, Ramesh was in charge of them. If you want to talk to Ramesh, you may.
The OC called Mr. Ramesh. Mr. Ramesh arrived.
Abhijit asked, do you know can you suspect the way of getting out from jail?
Mr. Ramesh answered,
no, sir, but we can suspect that he ran at night. But from where?
It may be through the door or window. For sure there is no underground tunnel.
Abhijit said, how do you know there is no underground tunnel?
Mr. Ramesh said, with drops of sweat in his face.
Sir, there is no trace of that. We are tracing whether the doors or windows are okay or not.
Abhijit said, so two of his companions are still in jail. Have you questioned them?
No, sir. We are quite busy these days, as from our head departments, many works are coming.
And the real work isn't done, right?
Anyways, have you assured that his companions would not get away to run?
Sir, we are checking the doors and windows.
Question those two and try to take out every bit from them.
Was Pawan Singh and both of his companions kept in the same lockup?
No, sir. They were kept in separate lockups, said Mr. Ramesh.
Can I visit the one in which he was kept?
Sure, sir. Come with me.
They went and saw the lockups in which he was kept.
Abhijit started checking every walls and the floor. No trace of any underground tunnel was found. Even the bed was moved. He checked the window and then came back.
Achintya asked, we went there, but why didn't we question Pawan Singh's companions?
Questioning is not my work. Police may do that. Now, let's move towards Hussain Sagar.
Abhijit called up their driver, Mr. Santosh, and moved towards Hussain Sagar.
Abhijit said, we will see Charminar some other days. Today, only Hussain Sagar.
How many days are we going to stay in Hyderabad? Asked Achintya.
Are you worrying about your business? Didn't you keep that boy in charge of your business? Said Abhijit.
Yes, I did.
Achintya understood they are going to stay here for quite some days.
4.
After watching the beautiful model of Buddha, they were delighted. At least Achintya was. He could realize that sometimes his brother was coming to normal mood, while sometimes his brother was going to tense mood. They returned at Hotel Prakash in the evening. Around 7 p.m., there was a knock at the door. Nobody rang the bell. Achintya went and opened the door. Abhijit was in the bathroom. As Abhijit came out, he saw Achintya standing at the door with a white paper. Abhijit ran to him. Achintya closed the door and said, there was a knock at the door. I opened and saw only this piece of paper.
Abhijit took the paper from him.
Some block letters were written on it. They were, quit from work.
Achintya got afraid, but Abhijit said, good. The opponent party knows at least we came here. Now, the real game starts.
After a minute or two, there was a call. It was Mr. Sushant. He said whether they are in the hotel or not, or whether he can come that time or not. He has got something to convey to them. He arrived by the next 20 minutes. Mr. Sushant said, so, you couldn't control your curiosity. Good, good. The police questioned the two companions.
What's the result? Asked Abhijit. Only one thing came out of them. That is, Pawan Singh is doing all these. They had planned to do all these things before they were arrested. Some of his companions, whom we cannot catch last time, had been planning things till now. Did they find? How did Pawan Singh escape? That's not important. The only important thing is that to catch him, said Mr. Sushant. That may be important at times, sir. Anyways, will you have tea? Thanks, said Mr. Sushant. Achintya ordered 3 cups of tea for them. Mr. Sushant began. So, Achintya, how did you find Charminar and Hussain Sagar? Achintya said, Hussain Sagar was amazing. We didn't visit Charminar today. We will visit that some other day. Just as the tea came and Mr. Sushant took up a pakoda, Abhijit said, But our villain got the news. Very clever villain indeed. The villain knows where we live. Means? Asked Mr. Sushant. So, listen this. Evening, someone knocked at the door. When Achintya opened, he saw just a paper in which it was written, Quit from work. Means the opponent team member might have followed you, but you didn't give your real identity to anyone, did you? No. Only the OC of the police station knows. And how will the opponent party know I am investigating this case? That's another mystery, said Sushant. You were listening to Achintya and Abhijit Banerjee's Detective Stories, Part 1. Thank you. Hope you liked it.